Greeting viewers, I'm Faida dan Ainin Tias. I'm coming from MTS Kota AIN. Our top story today are about Indonesian Independence Day. We begin today with breaking news from the Indonesia. The nation is celebrating its independence with happiness and pride as marked the anniversary of the declaration of independence from the Dutch colonial era. Back on 1945, Indonesia proclaimed its independence, a historic moment that has happened not too long ago. Today, across the moment of Independence Day, Indonesians are engaging in a range of activities, from traditional ceremonies to a vibrant parade, and with the President Joko Widodo's speech.
Sangat mungkin ada celah dari langkah-langkah yang saya ambil, dan sangat mungkin banyak kealpaan dalam diri saya.
Now, Indonesian President Joko Widodo delivered a stirring speech earlier today, emphasizing the nation's progress and commitment to unity and development. He highlighted the achievement in the Paris sector and expressed gratitude for the resilience and dedication of the Indonesian people. In the other side, the alleged prohibition for member of the 2024 flag-raising troop Paskibraka to wear the hijab while on duty at the August 70 ceremony has triggered widespread and violent action from the community, religious figure, and various other parties. Indonesian society is again shocked by a sensitive issue ahead of the Independence Day commemoration. This issue emerged after a short video circulated on social media showing Paskibraka member training at the national level with an instructor who allegedly prohibited the use of the hijab while on duty. This viral video immediately attracted public attention and invited further speculation. Many parties demanded clarification from the government, especially from the Ministry of Youth and Sport, Kemenpora, which is responsible for implementing Paskibraka. This allegation further strengthened concern about discriminatory practice against Muslim women who want to express their belief through the hijab. The head of UMSIDA Law Study Program responded to the ban on Paskibraka hijab wearing. Head of the Law Study Program from the Faculty of Business, Law and Social Science, FBHIS UMSIDA, Dr. Lydia Serim with SHMH MKN assessed that if there really is such a ban, it is a form of discriminatory that violates human rights. Freedom of religion is a right guaranteed by our Constitution. Article 28A, paragraph 1 of the 1945 Constitution clearly states that everyone is free to embrace religion and worship according to their belief. This ban, if true, is a violation of constitutional right and discrimination against Muslim women who want to express their belief, said the head of Law Study Program. Article 281, paragraph 1 of the 1945 Constitution also states that the right to religion is a part of human right that cannot be reduced under any circumstance. In other words, the state has an obligation to ensure that every citizen, including Paskibraka member, can practice their belief and without pressure or coercion to confirm the role that they do not respect diversity. Maybe that's all from us today. We thank you for joining us. Have a peaceful day. I'm Faizadin and yes, goodbye.